After all the theory, I'm now gonna make a deep dive and show you a real-life application example. I've now opened the tool VectorConnector software, the MQTT basic connectivity demo that is shipped with the standard installation of VectorConnector software. And I'm gonna show you now in detail what I've covered so far in the presentation. We have here some trace windows that will show us the communication between the backend and Canoe, and in detail the distributed objects we have defined in our software model. I will open the corresponding VCDL file. You have our climate simulations. We have here an object, the iClimate control, where we consume temperatures from our different rooms. We have the upper left temperature, the lower left temperature, the upper right temperature, and the lower right temperature. And we also consume from our backend the fan speed, which is then in Canoe for software presented as rotation speed. And after our interface definition, we have here the object of our climate control. Here we have the fan simulation, where we simulate our different fans. So the fan consumes our four temperatures, what we have defined above this section. We also consume the humidity in the room. And with these parameters, we make some magic calculation and provide the rotation speed of the fan onto the broker, and Canoe receives these values. And for some statistic reasons, we also calculate here our average temperature. With this defined interface of a fan, we have here now our object fan, what is later showed us in the analysis in the trace window. And here we have our temperature simulation, the temperature sensor with some wildcards that will allow us to save a lot of writing efforts, because we only need to define this interface one time. And here we create a lot of objects with some simple replace and search. And this will set this value def upper left in this placeholder, what is defined here. So here we have our four temperature sensors. And after these objects, we have our humidity simulation that will consume the average temperature and provide us the humidity of all the rooms, of all the room sensors. And here as well, the humidity sensor object that we will see later in our trace window. The other data here is for internal displaying reasons and has nothing to do what is exchanged to the backend and back. So with this model that is defined here, we have here our applications models. These are C# files where we have all the logic that interacts with our backend. We have here our fan simulation, the humidity simulation, and the temperature simulation, which are three independent application models written in C# that contain all the logic and stuff. You can write these application models in Cpl and Python as well. So there are at the moment three languages that we are supporting to write these application models. So I will now start the measurement, take some time to compile the simulations model. And when this is done, we have now our connection into the vector backend in the GNU Communication Hub, and there were some values still valid in our backend. And I will now switch here to automatic mode, what simply sets some random values here in our temperature sensors. And after some time, when the temperature goes up, our fan here will start to move because it's too hot in our room. These are the objects that are in some interaction with the backend. The direction Rx means that we receive a value from the backend, and Tx means that we send some values into the backend. So here in our fan trace, we see all the objects that has to do with the fan simulation. And here down, all the values for the climate control. So we see the consumed temperature that are received from the backend. What I will show you now, we stop our measurement. We disable our fan simulation, and we replace this fan simulation now with a real system under test that is running somewhere in the internet. This example system under test is written in JavaScript and uses MQTT client, and we connect our system under test to our backend address. For this, we have our key file to identify the user. We have our certificate. We have our certificate authority. These are some security related objects to identify the user and to match system under test and GNU, that they can exchange data over the backend. Here we have our subscription to our object on the broker. And here is the message handler for this subscription, where we take the temperature, double it, and set this as the new speed. I will run the MQTT client. So there are no errors in the connection to the backend. I will now switch back to GNU for software. Start the measurement again. And let's see what happens in our trace window. We have here our climate control, which shows us the data. And as we made change to the model, now the rotation speed is nearly double the value of our temperature. So we have easily replaced our application model that is handled within GNU with a real system under test. I will switch back the automatic mode. And when we set here the value, it's doubled as expected. I will now reactivate our fan simulation and stop our system under test to show you another feature of Vector GNU for software, which is the automated tests. So here with this test modules, we can test our system under test in a very automated way without user interaction. For now, in our example, in our demonstration, I have stimulated system under test in a very, very manual way. And GNU for software offer us also to do this automated. So I will now start a measurement again, and here we run our test suite. These are also written in C#, but there is, like always in Canoe for software, possible to write this in Kappel and Python. There's something going wrong. Maybe I have to restart. Yep. Now our test suite is run successfully, and after our test run, we can have a deeper look into our test report. And here in our test report, we can see we have set the data in our backend, and the application model sent us the data back. And we have here some checks. And if the check is green, the check is passed. So we have our stimulation, and here we have our expected value, and we can match this expected value with the set value, and then we have a pass. What we can see as well are with the same possibilities with the trace window with the test, where we can see all the test steps that are happened to our system under test. After this application example, where we connected successfully a system under test to a backend, I'm now ready for your questions, and thank you very much.